And the cannoli, see?
I didn't want Taco Bell tonight, I'm excited.
What is that, Dick Tracy?
No, Sean Connery.
Something more like the guy from Dick Tracy.
Remember that?
I'm Sean Connery, welcome to the Rock.
Yeah, that was a good Connery right there.
You remember that movie he did with
Matthew McConaughey? That would be a good one.
It's McConaughey.
I know, but I'm combining the two names together.
That's fair. That is
fair. If you can do the Sean Connery, but like what he says, like,
have you ever drove a Lincoln?
What does Matthew McConaughey say?
All right.
Yeah, say it like Sean Connery. Say it like Sean Connery if you can. It's hard though.
All right.
It needs a lower register.
Remember when Sean Connery did that movie with the Jekyll and Hyde? It was like the 13.
No, dude.
Oh, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking of
Psycho.
No, where it was the Extraordinary Gentleman.
Yes, that's it.
That was his last movie.
That shit was awesome.
No, that was seriously his last movie. He just did that movie and he's like, yeah, I'm done. Fuck it. I need to make more of this kind of stuff.
You know you have a drinking problem when you spend more on chips than you do your beer.
You're right, that's a $2 bag of Montrose.
It's
a dollar. Here we go, folks. $1.50 plastic bottle. Beast. This is the beast. $2 bag of Montrose. This exists. Oh, and look at their advertised 6.9 alcohol. That's pretty high for a beer.
It is.
Go beast.
I wish you could take the $2 sticker.
Well, I could.
It's not a sticker, though.
Doesn't have to be.
$2 at? That's how he's going to eat the chip. Where are we going to put it? Put it on the beer. It should stick, honestly.
Right. Get the fuck this shit.
My man wanted this.
It looks like it looks like baby wipes now. Okay. It's coming. Fuck. Put it on.
You guys fucked up my beast.
It's your $2 beast. We're talking about how you spent more money on chips than you did your own beer.
That's true.
We're like, we know you got a drinking problem when you spend more on chips than you do your beer. So you can get more.
It's like spinning.
You got some baby wipe chips here.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
Oh, God.
Oh, it hurts the cheekbones. Yeah. Oh. We're saying all this while listening to this fucking song.
This is perfect. This is raw.
Oh, quality entertainment. Alright. You guys want to hear a funny story? Okay, so... And I actually have video proof of this. This isn't just some random gamer ranting about stupid shit that he can't prove. Ah, fuck. So... Here. What is it? This is the actual cart that the story is based on. This is like the actual physical cart. So I bought that game when I moved out to Kent, and my roommate and I had, like, this is back when we seriously were just out of high school. We had absolutely no goddamn money. Like, nothing. Like, dude, if you look at pictures of our apartments, we had one of those spools that, like, you put wire on. You know, like, you know, the spools that have wire on it. As a table and two lawn chairs with a TV on top of another spool. Like, that's all we had. And I had, you know, I had all my video game systems. So we got Smash Bros. With our, you know, we actually both saved up to get Smash Bros. All right, and then, we had nothing else to play, so we played the shit out of Smash Bros. Well, I started playing as Jigglypuff, because it was funny, because Jigglypuff is by far the worst character in, like, any video game in that game. You know, they actually ended up making her, like, one of the best characters in the new ones, but in the 64 one, she's terrible. She has no power moves whatsoever. You know, she dies at 50%. Like, it's just, everything about Jigglypuff is bad. So I was like, screw it, I'm gonna become the master of Jigglypuff. Like, I'm gonna defeat everybody with the worst character. So for a year, and my roommate Billy made me promise, and he made sure I never played with anybody except Jigglypuff for like a year, and I got so good. Oh, wait. What? Whatever, Jigglypuff. Alright, so I got Jigglypuff, really good with her, and then I just started destroying everybody to the point where, like, people would come over and say they'd play with me as long as I wasn't Jigglypuff. So, that's what I mean, I probably need some practice. I'm a little out of practice. Like, I probably haven't played it since I started streaming, because it got to the point just no one would play with me anymore. And I just really want to get back into it a little bit. Like, I used to be able to take on three computers at level 9. Like, that was my practice, is put three computers at level 9. For warm-up! Like, that would be my warm-up. Like, okay, I'm good, let's go. So I need to get back to that for sure. I've had so many people say, too, like, you need to play in a tournament. But, like, no one plays that game in tournaments anymore. They always play Brawl. It's like, I can't stand the GameCube controller. Like, it's one of the worst controllers ever made. And I would love to play in a Smash tournament if they played the 64. But, oh, so here, to continue the story. This cart right here, we played this game so much that if you go to the data screen, anyone who knows the game, there's a data screen, and it shows how many times you've killed each player. You know, there's a grid, and it'd be like Mario, Mario, Luigi. So you can figure out, like, who you played and how many times you killed that person with each person. We played it so much that we filled every box to 9999. That's 10,000. So this is the video evidence I still have. So I got out my camera, little Nokia camera, right? And we had just played the last match to fill in the last box with all nines. So I recorded that match. So then we exited the match and we went to the data screen and it froze. I was like, oh shit. So I reset it. This is in the video. So I reset it. We go back to the data screen and it froze. It couldn't load the information. It couldn't fathom the fact that we had played it so much that there were all nines in every box. And I had to reset it to just to even play it again. Because anytime you tried to, like, get some data, like, it would pause. So, like, we would be able to play a match. But then at the end of the match, the game would pause because it couldn't upload the data that we had just created for that game. So I had to, like, reset the game and it was sad as shit. I almost felt like buying a new copy just to, you know, like, have that game. So, I mean, it's just a fun story. And I got the video somewhere. Maybe I'll put it on my YouTube. But it's just funny that, like, just two people. Now, granted, we had random people play with us at times, but, like, just two dudes just sitting around in an apartment with nothing better to do playing Smash Bros.
Fuck, I knew that was gonna fucking happen. I knew that was gonna fucking happen. That's my one game. It only lasts about 5 minutes, but we got 3.2 million. It's not that bad. It really is. It really isn't that bad. Like, fucking casual. Maddening, though. That first ball was great, though. We had a couple jackpots going. So let's raid this guy. We have to, everybody raid him and then leave. Here's the raid message. Engage your audience. You guys have to say that. And I'll see what he's up to for like a minute. But then I have to go jack off or something. Maybe eat, I don't know. I gotta fucking work in the morning. So we're gonna raid this guy. He's only got, just say that to him. Promise me, please, that would mean so much to me. I'm going to hit it right now. Engage your audience. All right, much love, you guys. Thanks for watching me play pinball.
Engage your audience. Okay, for those who don't know, this is the infamous, the well-renowned, the one, the only benevolent dick. He's probably one of my favorite YouTubers / Twitch players. He's hilarious. If you haven't checked out his channel, you definitely need to. He drums from one drummer to another, my man. He'll play this like 8-bit shit and then just destroy drums on it. It's great. So definitely check out his channel. And For those who are just joining then, welcome. I'm playing a really shitty ROM hack of Mario 3.
Heard cheeseburger, did you?
Dude, I don't think anyone's heard cheeseburger except us.
Let's break it down for Twitch and Anthony right now.
I never heard cheeseburger.
Well, okay, well, the story was, what, we were in Eaton Park, I think it was?
Eaton Park smoking section.
That's right, back when there was a smoking section.
Yes.
And there was a table of people that we didn't know. Yeah. I don't know, did you know anyone at the table? Because I didn't know anyone at the table.
I don't think we did, no.
I don't think we didn't know anyone there. But it was, you know, it was kids like us, like our age at the time. And so we went over there, and he just started beatboxing this beat. I never heard it before. I looked to the person next to me, and they had a burger, and I just started rapping random shit about a cheeseburger. And, dude, they were laughing their ass off. And I remembered exactly what I said, and he remembered his beat. And it's the dumbest song ever, but it's kind of funny.
Ready? Here we go.
This is how it goes.
Here we go.
Cheeseburger, cheeseburger, cha-cha-cha-cha, cheeseburger, cheeseburger, hold the pickles on my cheeseburger, cheeseburger, cha-cha-cha-cha, cheeseburger, cheeseburger, hold the cheese and make a burger, 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 hold the lettuce on my burger, 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 hold the ketchup on my burger, 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 pass the cheese on my cheeseburger, cheeseburger, cha-cha-cha-cha, cheeseburger, cheeseburger, hold the pickles on my cheeseburger, cheeseburger, cha-cha-cha-cha, cheeseburger, cheeseburger, hold the cheese and make a burger, 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 hold the pickles on my burger, 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 hold the lettuce on my burger, 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 burger. That's the whole song, it's a burger, burger, burger.
That's hard.
I don't even think we went that long at the table either. I think it was just like one rendition of it, but
no.
That was the cheeseburger song. It was all ad-lib. Like, I didn't know he was going to do that. He didn't know I was going to do that. And it just happened.
Remember that time we got really drunk and we ran across Route 8?
Somehow we're still here.
We were running away. We were running from cops or something. You know on,
what?
Yeah! Hudson Drive. Like, Bailey Road, Hudson Drive. You know that like, fenced-in place that's filled with all, like, the bricks and rocks that you can buy for, like, supply?
Yeah.
We jumped the fence, and we were, like, hiding, and I remember this.
Yeah, I called it a Spider-Man expedition, because I wanted to jump from one place to the next. I thought I was Spider-Man.
We were so fucked up when we were doing that, and then, like, we thought someone was, like, after us. We ended up literally running. We scaled, like, a fucking wall.
I know where you're at.
It was, like, 2 a.m., where the Acme is right there, right?
Yep.
We ran across the fucking highway, median and everything, and then got...
Oh my God.
No, I remember we got a bunch of 2 liters, and I threw one over the gate, and it exploded on the highway, and luckily no one wrecked. I was like, fuck this. It's like a grenade. Grenaded the highway off of the bridge. It's like 3 stories up, and just... God, we are such a jackass as a kid. I guess some things don't change.
The funny part was I was like 15, 16 at the time, and he was like, what, how old are you?
I'm 33 now.
Yeah. I'm 20 now. Okay, 4 years. So yeah.